Figma recently announced some amazing updates, including their new product, Figma Slides. Now, designers can create stunning interactive slide decks by pulling designs directly from Figma without switching between apps. In this video, we will cover the basics of this new tool, also show you how to implement great mockups to make your slide deck shine. Whether you are working on a product, website, branding design, or packaging, if you are using Figma Slides to present your work, you will love the combination of Figma, the Artboard Mockup plugin, and Figma Slides. Let's get started without further ado. With the new update, you will see a new slide deck button on the Figma dashboard. It shows a pop-up with templates to start with, or you can always start from scratch for creating a slide deck from your Figma project. To keep it brief, I will choose a template from the design and research category, specifically the one designed to showcase a phone app, and I will place better mockups to placeholder images. When you click on the thumbnail, it shows several page layout options. You can select one layout by clicking on it or click the Use Template button to start, quickly adding other pages with different layouts from the same template. Now, it is time to place our own mockups to these slide decks. There are several ways to do that. Option 1 is to create a new Figma design file, make mockups, and transfer them to the Figma slides. You can also use existing design files. Here, I will create my mockups using my design. First, go to the Actions menu and type Artboard Mockups. If you have installed our plugin, it will automatically open. If not, you can install it easily, just like over 600,000 other Figma users. It's simply the best mockup plugin for Figma. In the plugin window, choose from thousands of mockup categories like screens, devices, packaging, apparel, and print. You can also filter to view and import only free options from the drop-down menu here. Click on the thumbnail and import the mockup item to your canvas. The mockup item comes with an empty frame beside it. Place your design inside this frame. Select and click Render selected frame in the plugin pop-up. Your design is now on the iPhone screen. It's time to add this mockup to Figma Slides. The easiest option to select the frame with the mockup item and copy it by pressing Command or Control C. Switch to Figma Slide project and press Command or Control V to paste it. Now you can delete the placeholder image here and place the mockup anywhere you like. To scale up the mockup size, use the bottom toolbar scale option or press the key from the keyboard. Note that resizing a Figma frame will only change the frame size, not the content inside. Now, let's create another mockup for the second page. Again, switching back to Figma design file, choosing another mockup. Let's go with this iPad mockup now. Again, placing my design and rendering on the iPad screen. Copying the frame, going to Figma Slides, and paste it. Now, as you see, there's a ground shadow behind the iPad because this is just a frame with PNG images. You can always enable design mode from the bottom menu and adjust any settings directly inside Figma Slides. The moment you enable design mode, it brings layers and also changes the right sidebar with different functions. Here you can simply choose shadow layer and adjust the opacity as you like. Once you are done editing, disable the design mode. Now, let's talk about another way of bringing mockups into your slide deck. Instead of bringing PNG image layers, you may want to keep it live and see changes in real time inside the mockup item. For that, we will use prototype importing option. Let's go to the third slide and back to the Figma design file. Again, choosing another mockup and importing to my canvas. Placing my design, rendering on the device. But this time, I will select the frame and go to the top right present button. This will open the prototype mode with the selected frame. Now I can click share button and copy the link. Switch to Figma Slides again, go down and live interaction menu. Choose the prototype option and paste the link here. Then press Add button. It will add the prototype into the slide deck. You can resize and position like a normal frame, But because this is a live prototype link, if you change the mockup item, it will instantly reflect your changes in the slide deck. This way, you don't need to copy and paste all the time when you make a change in your Figma design project for this mockup. Now, if I go back to Figma design editor and change the design of the mockup item, my slide deck will also update it in real time. But the problem with this approach is you cannot crop and resize. You cannot apply transparent background to the mockup frame because this is simply prototype window. The last approach is using components. Let's switch to fourth page, go back to Figma design file and make more mockups again. Choose another mockup, render your design, but this time we will create a component out of this frame. Select the frame, right click and choose create component. Then go to the project settings menu on top left, choose publish library. In order to publish assets, you need to move this project. You can choose an existing folder here. Before this video, I have created a project folder named mockups, and now I'm choosing this folder to move this project file. Lastly, I need to publish this component. Again, going to the file settings and choosing publish library option here. Coming back to Figma slides and going to bottom toolbar, and this time I'm choosing assets menu. Here I'm choosing add your own option to see my component libraries. And as you see, my component already appears here. Pressing add to file and integrating all components from this project. Now I can easily preview my components here to import into my slide deck design. The best part of this approach is you can easily see all of your components as a list and mockups right inside Figma slides without going back and forth to Figma design file. But the problem with this approach is that once you turn the mockup into a component, you can no longer render your designs. You need to add the same item, render again, and create another component. Yeah, these are all different options for you to import mockups inside Figma slides. It's totally optional and up to you to decide which approach is better for you. The point here is you can create amazing presentations with our mockups easily. If you want to give it a try to Artboard Mockups plugin, it's free to test with lots of free items inside. You can follow the same steps in this video to make amazing mockups for your designs and make your pitch decks more unique. Also, additionally, we have many free mockup files in Figma community. Dropping the link to our Figma community profile page for you to discover more and experience yourself. Yeah, take care. Bye.